as much as I love my parents, I love my friends, you know, they can't get it. They interpret the way that they interpret, and they deal with it the way they deal with it, but they can't get it. And it's not something you can explain. It's not something you can, it's something that you've lived or you haven't lived. You can have excellent social workers who will be very empathetic and very understanding and very, you know, but they themselves, they haven't lived through it, you know? Not putting down social workers. I think they're fantastic. I'm doing a master's in social work. I want to be a social worker. You don't necessarily need to have the lived experience to be a good social worker. But there's something about sitting down at a table with others who are living a situation that resembles yours. There's just all the masks that you would wear in society just all melt away. You can be yourself. You can really be yourself with them. It's like, of course, when you're with other young adults, you're still gonna, you know, you get some of the stuff out, but you get it out of the way, really. It's like, oh, you had, what diagnosis did you, I see you have a scar there. Tell me about that. It's like, oh, well, I had brain cancer. Oh, cool, me too, awesome. Where'd you get treatments? Where, you know, who's your oncologist? Who's, you know, it just, you get this in this like little, but it's not like a heavy conversation. It's like, oh, you know, well, I have brain cancer. It's like, oh, you have brain cancer too? Wow, that's so cool. Like, and then you kind of, there's a different energy about it. There's a different energy. It's not like you don't need to make excuses. You don't have to feel sorry for yourself. You don't have to feel sorry for the other person. And as soon as all of that goes away, you're people. You're just people sharing certain characteristics, and you're, like, I'm always able to joke around. I'm always able to laugh with whoever I am. But I know some young adults who need to be with other young adults to be able to be themselves, to be able to laugh, to be able to, you know, just have those conversations where they don't have to be thinking, oh no, did they see my scar? Did they, you know, am I acting okay? You know, how do I look right now? I hope it's okay if I have to leave because I'm tired. You don't have all these worries going on in your head. Or the worst thing is, I hope he doesn't find out that I have cancer. Because that's a big one. Especially when you're a young adult and you're dating. That's scary. Because, you know, you don't want to, well, especially with a terminal cancer diagnosis, my God. You know, that's the least thing. You sit down at a restaurant and it's like, so I'm gonna die soon. I have a terminal cancer diagnosis. Oh my God. The other person would, I'm sure, just, you know, well, we're in Canada, so everyone's a little polite. So they'll be like, oh, okay. And they'll finish their meal and they'll be like, bye. I hope you're gonna be okay. You know, you're not treated like a sad little puppy dog. You're treated like a person. And that's what's great about it. That's what's great about sitting with young adults, with other young adults who've experienced cancer, who know what it's like, who really get it. Because with everybody else, when you're talking about that stuff, you're not having a conversation, you're talking at them. Whether they know it or not, or whether they realize it or not, you end up having to talk at them instead of talking with them.